Hi. In this tutorial, we will make a simple transparent glass and decorative glass material. First, create a material and open the material window. Next, set the blend mode to translucent and the lighting mode to surface translucency volume. Next, change the constant 3 vector as a parameter to set the color and connect it to the base color. Next, create a parameter named roughness so you can adjust its value. Then, we connect this to roughness. Next, create a Fresnel node and a Lerp node. Next, let's adjust the metallic value to add a glass-like gloss and reflection value. Create parameters that divide the metallic node into inner and outer values and connect them to the Lerp node. And connect the Fresnel node to Lerp's alpha value, and then connect it to the metallic. In simple terms, you can think of Fresnel as a node that expresses refraction according to the angle the observer looks at. Next, in order to make the material transparent, the opacity is divided into an inner value and an outer value in the same way as the method of creating the metallic value, and the parameters are connected to Lerp and Fresnel is used as the alpha value. If you connect it to the opacity, you can see the material become transparent. Next, connect the two constants to Lerp to express the refraction of the glass and get the value of Fresnel as alpha. One of the constants will be changed to parameter, so we will control the value later. If you want, you can take both as parameters like before. The basic transparent glass material is now completed. Next, we will make decorative glass. Create a cobblestone normal provided by Start Content and use the Text Coord Multiply node and parameters to scale the UVs. Next, create a power node to control the strength of the normal and connect it with parameters. Now, let's use the switch node to enable or disable that normal value. Next, we will create a static bool parameter and connect it to the value of the switch node already created so that we can see the true false value in the instance. Now, connect the switch node to the normal node, and you're done. Save and exit to the content browser. Create an instance of the glass material you just created and apply it to the mesh. Open the instance window and adjust the desired value.